Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how to enable editing options in the Blazor data grid and its different cell edit types. You will also see the different editing modes and how to add a custom editor component in the data grid. I hope everyone is familiar with WebAssembly app creation and how to add Syncfusion Blazor components to it. If you'd like to review the process, you can watch the video linked in the above card. Now, I will open my existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I have added the Blazor data grid with order list data. If you need to know how to bind data to the Blazor data grid, then you can follow the above card to watch my data binding video. Also, you can download a data binding sample from the GitHub link shared in the description below. Now, I'll run this example and show you the output. Here, I have loaded order data displayed with certain columns like order ID, customer ID, freight, order date, and ship country. Next, I'll show you how to enable editing options in the data grid. By default, the data grid supports options to add a new record, delete and update existing records. For these functionalities, I need to define the isPrimaryKey property as true in the order ID column, as I'm going to maintain this column with unique values. Now, to enable the editing options in the data grid, first I need to include the grid edit settings tag inside the Blazor data grid code. Then I'll enable the allow adding, allow editing, and allow deleting properties to be able to perform the add, edit, and delete operations in the data grid. Next, I'm going to show how to display toolbar options in a data grid. The available toolbar options are add, edit, delete, update, and cancel. First, I need to declare a variable toolbar items to assign the value in the form of list of string or list of toolbar items or combination of both. Now, I'm going to assign a value add, edit, delete, update, and cancel in the form of list of string. Then I'll assign this variable to the toolbar property of the grid. Here you can see the data grid enabled with the toolbar with edit options. You can add a new record by click on the add button and edit a record by click on the edit button after selecting a row. Also, you can edit a record by double clicking its row. We can delete a record by click on the delete button after selecting a row. Next, I will show you the different cell edit types available in the data grid component. Numeric text box, drop-down list, checkbox, date picker, and date time picker. By default, Blazor data grid has a support to set the edit type based on the column data type. The text box cell edit type, which is a default type, used to display string values. A numeric text box used for integer, double and decimal data types, date picker for date data type, date time picker for date time data type, and checkbox for boolean value. Here, when I edit a record, you will notice that textbox is enabled for customer name column, date picker is enabled for order date column, and numeric textbox is enabled for freight column. Suppose I want to change the built-in edit type for any grid column, I'll need to use edit type property. Here, I'm going to display drop-down list for ship country column. So let me define the edit type property and set its value to drop-down edit. Look at the output now. When I edit on the record, you can see the drop-down editor for ship country column. I can also customize the behavior of the editor component through the editor settings property of the grid column tag. Here, I'm going to customize the default date picker component in the grid editor form using date edit cell params class. I can customize the date picker component with properties like CSS class, enable RTL, read only, and show clear button. Let me show you how to hide clear button in date picker. First, I include the Syncfusion Blazor calendar's namespace Inside the atco directive, I will declare the public variable DateEditParams of type iEditorSettings. Then I create an instance of DateEditCellParams and define the field params. Using the instance of DatePicker model, I will add the showClearButton property and set its value to false. Then I will assign this variable to the EditorSettings option of the orderDate column. Now, when I double-click the records, you can see the clear button is hidden in DatePicker for orderDate column. Apart from the built-in edit types, you can also use custom editor components in a grid columns by using the edit template tag. So now I will show you how to display an autocomplete component in a customer ID column. To work with the Syncfusion autocomplete component, first I need to import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor dropdowns. Then within this customer ID column, I will add the edit template tag and include the tag SF autocomplete. Next, I'll define the data source property and set its value as orders. For this data source property, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the autocomplete component. Therefore, I need to define the autocomplete field settings tag and map the field customer ID to the value property. For this autocomplete component, I need to specify the data source type, so let me define a property tItem and set its value as ordersDetails. Then I also need to specify the autocomplete value field type, so I will set tValue as string. I need to define addBindValue property with the value customerID to support two-way binding across the Blazor data grid and autocomplete components. So here you can see the grid component, and when I double click on the record, the customer ID column is displayed with the autocomplete editor. Next, let me show you the different types of editing modes available in the data grid. They are normal, dialog, and batch mode. So far, the examples I have shown you are enabled with a default normal mode, and when you double click the grid record, editor will be shown inline. Next, I will demonstrate the dialog editing mode. To enable the dialog edit mode, I need to define the mode property inside the grid edit settings tag and set its value to dialog. Look at the output page now. When I start to edit the record, the dialog will pop out. Here I can edit the existing grid records and save the changes by clicking the save button or discard them by clicking cancel. Suppose I would like to edit and save the changes as a bulk to grid data source, I can use the batch mode. To enable batch editing mode, I need to change the mode property value to batch inside the grid edit settings tag. See the output page now. I can edit multiple grid records by double clicking the cells. You can see the editor cells are highlighted and it can be saved using update option in the toolbar. Finally, I will show you how to disable the editing options for a particular column. Here I'm going to disable editing for the freight column. So I will define the allow editing property and set its value to false. Also, I will change the edit mode to normal for better understanding. Look at the output page now. When I double click the grid row, the freight column is in a disabled state. Now let me quickly recap what we have seen in this video. We have seen how to enable the editing feature of the Blazor data grid along with the grid's toolbar options. Next, we saw different cell edit types and editor modes supported in the data grid component. Also, I have shown you how to add a custom editor component and autocomplete component in our example to the Blazor data grid. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.